Hey guys, HDV here, and welcome to a brand new video. Today we've got some pretty interesting things to go over for Pokemon Legends Arceus, because a new leaked image has surfaced about the upcoming game. We think it's a leaked image. It doesn't appear anywhere on the Pokemon websites or any of the trailers released so far, so this image seemingly is a leaked one. As well as that, we have a few other things to go over that you guys might have missed out on in the Pokemon Legends Arceus trailers. So if you're excited for the video, as always, make sure to drop a like down below. Let's try and hit 500 likes. It really does help out. Leave a comment as well with your thoughts on anything we cover in today's video. Make sure to subscribe for daily Pokemon content. With all of that out of the way though, let's get into the video, and I really hope that you enjoy. So, starting things off, let's talk about this new potentially leaked Pokemon Legends Arceus image. Now again, just like I previously mentioned, we think it's a leaked image because it doesn't appear anywhere on the Pokemon Legends Arceus trailers or any of the numerous Pokemon Legends Arceus websites. This is the only place that this image exists. So it was posted by James Card. They did quite a sarcastic tweet, to be fair. They said, "Just got sent a new totally legit leaked image. My insider uncle is working overtime for this forbidden gameplay." So obviously that's a very sarcastic tweet, but at the same time, it is an image that doesn't appear anywhere else. So we might even be in leaked season now, where we see quite a few of these as we get closer to the game's release. I'm surprised we haven't really seen any other leaked images for Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, seeing as they are coming out in November. Again, we have a rumored September Nintendo Direct happening very, very soon. So that could be where they show off more gameplay for Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl, Legends Arceus, or anything like that. We just have to wait and see. But yeah, this was posted by James Card. Again, the image doesn't really show anything crazy. It's very blurred. It does look like it was taken on a 1964 toaster, which doesn't really help us. But it looks like in the background, it is either the camp that you kind of go to where you craft things and you heal, and obviously if you're faint outside in the world of Legends Arceus by a boss Pokemon or whatever, you kind of get teleported back here and it's just kind of like a checkpoint, a spawn point, or it could be one of the Dialga tents. Now, I don't know if you saw my video recently where we went over more things that you might have missed in the Legends Arceus trailer, but basically on the world map for Legends Arceus, in the different locations, there's like people dressed up as like Palkia with like pink, like kind of tents, and then as well as that, there's people dressed up as Dialga with like bluish kind of tents. Now this obviously isn't blue, but it could just be like a model like that, or it could just be like a random little house that's just chilling. It looks like a little hut, to be fair, so I don't really know, but I think it's just one of the camp things. So again, like I say, this will be linked in the description down below. It doesn't really show a lot, but it's a leaked image, is what it seems to be. There's also been talking about this image on r/PokeLeaks as well. It was posted by Baby Pistolino. I probably got that wrong, I do apologize. And yeah, people are just kind of saying, yeah, it doesn't appear anywhere on websites, it doesn't appear anywhere on the trailers and stuff. So yeah, it does look like a leaked image. Like I say, the whole insider uncle thing is just kind of a, it's just a sarcastic comment to like all the rumors and stuff that you find that talk about like, you know, how they found out the information and stuff. And as well as that, we also have Eclipse talking about it as well, who is a insider or knows an insider. And they posted saying, "Seems like a new leaked image from Legends Arceus. If you find this anywhere on trailers or sites, mention me. On the right, I tried my best to improve the quality." So I don't know if Eclipse originally found this posted image or it was James. I'm not really sure, but yeah, Eclipse actually kind of improve the quality a little bit, so you can kind of make out more of this image. But at the same time, there isn't anything really crazy. Some people are thinking this is a Pukumuku in the bottom right. I don't know if it is or it's just a plant or something. Not really too sure about that, but I guess you can kind of make out the hut a little bit more. Again, this will be linked in the description down below. This is another image as well. I'm not sure if this is leaked or what, but this is just a random reply to the thread, so not really too sure what's going on with this one. This was posted by Fra, so again, like I say, this will be all linked in the description down below. But yeah, I'm not sure if Pukumuku was already confirmed for Legends Arceus, but it does kind of give Pukumuku vibes a little bit. I guess it could either be a plant or it could be a Pukumuku, so you guys can make up your mind on that one. But yeah, that's all of the stuff about the new leaked image. Again, we're only saying it's a leaked image because it's just not found anywhere else. So I don't know if it's just like what it is really, but yeah, we can't find it anywhere else. Next up, Stark Mountain seems to be back in Pokemon Legends Arceus as well. Now these were all posted like when the trailers came out for Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl, and Legends Arceus in the Pokemon Presents. I'm only now just getting around to kind of adding them all in. But this was posted by Mario Meister on the r/PokeLeaks Reddit. And as you can see, Stark Mountain seems to be in Pokemon Legends Arceus. So they put a ring around where it appears on the map, which is right up here. And then obviously over there in the top image, you can kind of see Stark Mountain as well. So this is probably like the location of the person where this photo was taken, which makes sense because obviously around here, you can see like the sea in the background. And obviously that's what the Stark Mountain is surrounded by. So we also have people posting about this saying, wanted to point this out since in the reveal trailer, the island in the northeast of Sinnoh was covered by clouds. And then we have Lorente saying the island does not appear to have been invested yet. Interesting. So yeah, Stark Mountain seems to be a location that is present in Pokemon Legends Arceus. And a big shout out to Mario Meister for discovering that. Next up, we have this, which was posted by WLS Gars, again, about 2 weeks ago. Only just getting to this now. But they found out a pretty cool detail in the Pokemon Legends Arceus trailer where they said, a neat detail. Not only does time of day affect the lighting in the world, there is dynamic lighting and shadows, unlike Sword and Shield, where it was all the same no matter the time of day. But people also go back into their homes during the night, it seems. So again, it's more or less just like another little added touch, which you wouldn't really necessarily see in Pokemon games. They've got a lot more time on their hands working on this game because, like I say, they don't even need to do anything about Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl because a completely different company is working on that. So yeah, they've got a lot more people just working on this so they can do these kind of quality of life changes and make the game look nicer. But yeah, as you can see, it's like the middle of the day here and people are outside just having a stroll. I think this is the Jubilife Village. And then next up on the next image, you can see that, well, it's nighttime now and everybody's gone inside. The lights are on. Again, just another cool little feature that a lot of people weren't really taking into account when obviously the trailer happens. When you watch the trailer and you're trying to get in all this information, you miss out on things like this, which is why it's really cool to have these kind of subreddits where people eagle-eyed just taking a look at all the trailers, breaking them down and finding out things like this. So big shout out to WS Garus for finding this one out. Next up, we have another post from WLS Garus, again, around 2 weeks ago when the trailers dropped. And they say here, this is not concrete proof whatsoever, but it is curious that when the player goes to rest at the camp, they get up later in the day. I wonder if that means time of day is no longer tied to real life time and instead an in-game timer. Probably not, but we'll see. It is possible, all things considered. So yeah. This is an interesting one. As you can see here, the protagonist is at one of the base camps, and when they rest and they like wake up, it is kind of like evening, while pre-evening is sunset and everything like that. So yeah, time of day seems to shift when you go and rest in the base camp. We have people here replying to this saying, I wouldn't be surprised if it is, considering how much inspiration it's already taken from Breath of the Wild. Honestly, it would be pretty neat. I think it would be neat as well. I think having your own in-game clock in the game instead of like real time, because with real time, you kind of just have to wait for things to happen. You know, obviously it's real time, so you have to wait real hours, real minutes, real seconds. Where if it's stuff like this, like if you need to skip to a certain time of day for a quest, it's going to be very easy to do that because you just go rest at the base camp or whatever and you're instantly there, whereas you'd have to wait like 6 hours or something in real time. So yeah, I hope that's a thing. It would be a really cool feature. And again, it has to, like that person said, it's taken a lot of inspiration from Breath of the Wild, so wouldn't surprise me if that is the case. Finishing things off, we have this post from Dexerto, which I didn't even think know about. I'm not sure if you guys did. I don't know if it was only posted on like a couple of little things, but there's actually another kind of pre-order bonus, and in this time it's the Garchomp kimono set. So obviously we all know that we get the Growlithe Hisuian set for pre-ordering the game, which is all cool, but there's also like a Garchomp one as well. I don't know if you guys knew about that. I definitely didn't know about it. But here they say the Pokemon Company is celebrating the release of its 2022 open world title with a limited time clothing item. Here is how to get the Pokemon Legends Arceus Garchomp kimono set. So it says the upcoming project has a second in-game clothing item that is based on a Sinnoh feature. This guide will break down how to unlock the Garchomp kimono set in the open world title. So this is the Garchomp set on the male protagonist and on the female protagonist. I like the look of it more on the female protagonist. I don't know, it just looks better in my opinion. But this is another costume or clothing item that, again, I wasn't sure about until I saw this. So unfortunately, although the Hisuian Growlithe kimono set is a worldwide promotion, the Garchomp version of the skin is exclusive to Japan. Japan getting everything for Legends Arceus. They're getting the really cool TCG card of Legends Arceus. As well as that, they're getting this this clothing item as well, which is just exclusive to Japan. So it says, fortunately, players from other regions can still get their hands on the special clothing item. So because the Nintendo Switch is not region locked, fans can still get their hands on a Japanese version of the game that will still work on their Nintendo Switch. Here are the easiest steps on how to secure the right edition of Legends Arceus and get the game, the Garchomp kimono set. So this is what you can do, obviously, to get this if you really want to. But I think what this means is that you have to buy the Japanese game just for this kimono set of Garchomp. So it's really up to you whether you want to fork out the extra money just for a clothing item, which you might not even like that much. Like, it looks pretty good, but I'm sure there's going to be like a bunch more clothing items and stuff as you progress through the game. Like, we already know we're getting the Growlithe one as well. So how much do you like this? Is it worth the extra like $50 or whatever? I don't really think so. Wait, I don't actually know, because it says click pre-order now and follow the checkout instructions. You can use any normal credit or debit card. You don't need Japanese one if you do go with a physical edition. Oh yeah, shipping is $12. Okay, yeah, never mind. No, you gotta pay a little bit more, unfortunately. So yeah, it is what it is. It's whether you want it or not. But yeah, there's a new clothing item there that I definitely didn't know about until seeing this article. So yeah, that is pretty much gonna be everything for today's video. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure to drop a like down below. Leave a comment as well with anything we covered in today's video. What are your thoughts on this new leaked image? Of course, it doesn't really show much, but it's a leaked image at the end of the day. It's not leaked gameplay or anything like that. It is just simply an image, as you can see. And yeah, let me know about everything else that we covered in today's video. Subscribe if you're brand new for daily Pokemon content. That's everything from me. Have a fantastic rest of your day. And until next time, peace.